So I'm joined here again by for the second half of the vote by Billy Mauseth and Bruce Dickinson, and they are from WaterBear College. Billy, talking to Bruce at the start of the half about the music industry changing. What are your thoughts about it? It's rapid, isn't it? The change, the technological change, and I think it's going to change even more after the COVID pandemic once that's over.
Yeah, I mean the big thing that's happened in our industry is a lot of artists, a lot of venues just haven't been getting the support that they need, you know? I was reading an article by the Nighttime Industries Association who are predicting that 80% of venues are gonna close by the end of March if they don't get any help, you know? So there's a real problem there just now. And I also know a lot of my friends are DJs, producers and things like that. It's not so bad on the producer side of things, but with all the DJs, have lost a lot of their gigs, and they're not getting any gigs coming in, you know. So I've heard about them going back to, you know, doing bricklaying and stuff like that, you know, yeah. Just because there's no work in the industry that they've worked in for most of their life. So it's really hard for a lot of them just now.
Yeah. What about live streaming, Billy? What do you think about that as an answer, or at least a partial answer? Obviously, it's never going to replicate being at a venue, but it means that it's more accessible to people who might not be able to get to the gig.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those things when this whole pandemic started, it was huge. Everyone was doing live streaming, you know. Everyone was doing live streams from. I mean, we done a couple of good ones with Fatboy Slim on a boat out at the wind farm. We done ones with Faithless and stuff up in the pod, which were really well received. I've seen a big dip in people watching the streams, and everyone's doing streams now as well, you know. So
yeah.
I think everyone's just looking forward to the venues opening again, you know. And with all this new vaccine that's coming now, there is light at the end of the tunnel. So I think they're predicting sort of September time where we might be, you know, well, late August, September time where we might be able to go to a gig again, or the clubs might open up again. So I think people are just looking forward to that now and starting to plan for them.
Yeah, exactly. Bruce, just tell us a bit about this course then, about when do the term times start, and a bit about people can take those first steps.
The timing is quite good, really, because the course will start in September. People are applying now, and the course commences in September in the normal academic terms. But there will be a power balance shift because of all the stuff that Billy's just been talking about. There will be venues that sadly will fall over, and some of them will be taken up by new management. And it's you can feel the old guard, people my generation, a lot of them retiring, they can't innovate fast enough, and you feel young people coming through, just in the same way they did in 2014. So the course is all about innovation, new business models. I don't think bands will tour anymore in a traditional way. I think you will have a show, it will always be streamed. I think it's likely to be similar for some aspects of DJing and producers as well. And a function of a college that's involved in higher education is to record this kind of development, you know, and be a central community so good practice can be shared. So I'd like to see our DJs and producers getting stuck in, and I feel actually really positive, because I love it, the fact that young people have got a bit of a chance to get in there.
Yeah.
And older people are getting out of the way a bit. I think it's a kind of punky feeling in the air, and I like it.